One of the most popular New Year's resolutions is to eat healthier. But you don't have to look so far if you want to eat healthy, because we've got Tate here who's going to give us some tasty options.
Yeah, we've got Tate Applegate from Olive Garden here in Fort Wayne. Thanks so much for coming in this morning again,
Tate.
That's
my pleasure.
And we're talking about some new dishes, and we're also going to be cooking this morning, too. So I'm going to let you kind of lead the way.
All right. Well, we'll get started today. First of all, I just want to thanks for having me. I really appreciate being here. Also, we're featuring a couple new dishes that are inspired by the Mediterranean. And what's great about these is here we are midweek through January, really trying to hold on to those New Year's resolutions, and even Olive Garden is offering something to not have you feel guilty about those, and they're delicious, flavor-filled dishes. So to get us started today, we're actually going to start on the sauté. Start with our olive oil here and do some garlic, just like you would at home. And you guys can kind of imitate this for you as well in your own home. And we're going to do here on the right our spiralized veggie pasta today is what
we're
going to kind of create and have you guys try that for us.
Cool.
Sure.
So yeah, go ahead. We'll get started. Have a bunch of time.
I'll just introduce what we have here. So we have our whole wheat linguine. Our whole grain linguine, which is a healthy choice for pasta.
Okay.
And I already have some cooked al dente style right here for us as well. And then kind of the unique feature is our spiralized veggie pasta, as you can see here.
All right.
This is something you can do at home as well with a spiralizer, or a lot of your local grocery stores will actually offer that already spiraled for you.
All
just
right.
Like that.
Awesome.
Nice, beautiful pasta shape there as well.
Let's get cooking, Tate.
Sure, yeah. Let's do it right here. Got some olive oil I'm going to add here to our pan.
And we've got the skillet heated up a little bit.
That's right. And minced garlic here.
Okay. Now, how many cloves do you usually recommend for something like this?
You know, 2 to 3. Everybody kind of has a palate preference.
Depends on how
garlic.
Much garlic
Yeah, exactly. I'm a big garlic guy, but maybe 2 to 3 cloves to be safe would probably be a good way to go.
And would you call this like a quick recipe if someone just wanted to get something done real quick?
Yes, exactly. That's why I wanted to present it for you guys today.
Yeah.
It makes it easy to do at home and, you know, just eat healthy in the new year. Everybody's holding on to those resolutions for 2018, and so that's what we really want to focus on. So we're going to start off with the olive oil and the garlic and get that nice little browning on the garlic like you would with your garlic and onions. And then we're going to add some butter as well and some white wine.
What
the white wine is going to do is it's actually going to kind of simmer down, and it's going to give you a little bit of a tangy flavor, almost a sweet flavor as well that brings to the sauce.
Okay.
So we have some white wine here we're going to add as well. Kind of put that into our saute pan here.
Nice.
Yeah, so we'll just kind of let those things kind of saute together and mix the flavors here. And Rob, I'll actually have you take over as I slide over, and we'll do the second portion of our dish today, which is our aromatic mix. This is really interesting, definitely inspired by Italy and specifically the Calabria area of Italy, and that's where we get our Calabrian paste. So I'm going to start putting some things together here for us.
All right, start some
tomatoes. We have our grape tomatoes, our sliced grape tomatoes.
Okay.
We're going to throw those in our mixing bowl here.
And you said aromatic. It smells very aromatic in
that's
the studio.
Right.
It smells very, very good.
Well, it's got to smell good. Otherwise, nobody's going to go for it, right?
What are these?
And right here, I'm adding our sun-dried tomatoes. So you actually have the Roma tomatoes and the sun-dried tomatoes. We have our caramelized garlic. And you may have seen this from previous time I was here before. We did our Asiago garlic Alfredo. This is what's on top of that sauce as well.
Okay.
And then there's that Calabrian paste. And that's going to give a little kick to our dish.
Nice.
It's a little bit spicy. It's a red pepper paste.
Okay.
So we're going to add that in there as well.
And Tate, we're almost out of time. I don't mean to rush you, but
that's okay.
What are the last couple ingredients here as we mix
them together? So you know what? This is it right here, actually. So we're going to go ahead and put our pasta on our plate over here to the right.
Okay.
Do a little al dente pasta right here.
Might have to put the menus down there, Kaitor, so the folks can see.
Yeah, sure. That's fine. Absolutely. And then we have our spiralized veggie noodles right here. I'm going to put those on top.
Nice.
Our sauce is working over there.
Good healthy option.
That's right.
I would say this actually looks healthy. You know,
it
you just
does.
Look at something.
It's
and
pretty,
just
right? A lot of different colors with the green and the yellow and the zucchini and squash, and then this red is really going to make it pop as well. This is our aromatic mix. It's really, really delicious. It's something different, too. That's why we're so excited at Fort Wayne Olive Garden. Everybody definitely feel free to come on and try these dishes.
Great.
So we have our veggie spiralized pasta, and the one to my left here is our chicken Giordano. And that's it's like a pot pie opened up, right? You got the nice pepperdelli pasta and things like that, and the chicken on top. It's a beautiful dish.
Great.
And so this is our little mock spiralized
dish. Well, Tate, thank you so much. We'll let this continue to caramelize, but you can check out Olive Garden here in Fort Wayne. We'll be right back.